Welcome to KELA's Let's Talk About It. Discussions on a variety of topics of interest to Southwest Washington area listeners. Write down our listener call-in number and keep it handy. 330-5352. That's 330-KELA. You're invited to join in with your calls now at 330-KELA. Views expressed on this show are those of the host, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or advertisers. Daily programs are recorded for playback, podcasts, and promotional purposes. And now, let's talk about it.
Good morning. Welcome back to the Let's Talk About It show, AM 1470 KELA and KELAAM.com. I'm your host, Peter Abbarno, and chewing gum, drinking coffee, Kim Witham, taking calls. We are going to be talking today about the Forgotten Children's Fund, and I've had Kim on and the Forgotten Children's Fund on yearly to talk about all the amazing things they do in our community. This year, it's going to look different. It's going to look different for the Forgotten Children's Fund. It's going to look different for a lot of different charitable organizations, but that is no reason to throw your hands up and say, I'm taking my ball and going home. This is the time where our community, especially our community, has always stepped up and gone the extra mile to make sure we take care of our neighbors. And so I have Kim here talking about the Forgotten Children's Fund and really kind of charitable organizations, big hearts, Merry Christmases. We're going to deliver Santa in every home. Maybe not every home, but every home deserves a Santa. Kim, how are you today?
Good morning. Thank you for having us once again. I think we're on our seventh season here with the Forgotten Children's Fund in Lewis County. And the organization has been around for 44 years, and I'm so honored to still participate, even with all the restrictions that we are navigating around.
Yeah, and the Forgotten Children's Fund, and I had posted earlier about this on social media, about how near and dear the Forgotten Children's Fund is, because I remember probably 3 or 4 years ago, you said, hey, Peter,
I'm desperate.
I need a Santa. And I'm like, well, I can't gain weight that quickly. But I jumped in. And what a really a life-changing organization, because, you in the past, and we're going to talk a little bit about how things change a little bit, but, you know, you bring a Merry Christmas to a lot of families and children who otherwise may not have a Christmas. And what a horrible kind of thought that a child will wake up or have a holiday season and Santa didn't come to their house and then go to school and see all these other kids where Santa showed up.
Correct. It's an impact that it stretches across the board. It's not just about not coming on December 25th. Right. It's about being forgotten.
Yeah. And
we hope to bring hope.
And we hope to bring hope. And so give us a quick, and if you want to join in the conversation, I'm going to start taking some calls pretty soon, 360-330-5352, if you want to talk about this issue in charitable organizations and how the Forgotten Children's Fund, maybe you were impacted by the Forgotten Children's Fund. Maybe you're a volunteer and you want to talk a little bit about how important it is. But talk to me a little bit about the history of the Forgotten Children's Fund, because it's nice to lay that kind of foundation for people to understand kind of how it got started and what you really do.
So in 1976, a little boy named Craig left a letter in a restaurant called Francisco's in Seattle, and an attorney picked it up and a waitress, and they thought it was horribly sad that this child thought he would be forgotten. And I think his PS is, don't bring anything for daddy, he doesn't live here anymore, at the end of the letter. And it's heart-wrenching. I mean, you and I have read that letter very...
Do you want me to read it again?
Sure, go ahead.
And we'll
go
see which one of us tears up first, right?
Give it to you.
So here's the letter that this little boy wrote to Santa, and it didn't get to the Santa in the North Pole, but it got to people with huge hearts mm-hmm. who have a huge Santa in their heart.
Correct.
And so it says, Dear Santa, Mama said you got lost last year and couldn't find your way to our house. We really miss you, especially my little sister. Please come this year. Santa, we are being very good. Mama says you'll get lost again, maybe. So here's a map. Love, Craig. P.S. Don't leave anything for Daddy because he isn't here anymore. How just heart-wrenching is that? I know you and I were looking at each other and pointing because our eyes are both a little welling, because not only have we read this letter before, and having kids, it really impacts you when they talk about Santa, but we've also been in homes mm-hmm. where children don't expect a Santa, or Santa has missed their house before because their parents don't have the means. And regardless of what you feel socially, economically about the situation, mm-hmm. no innocent child deserves to be punished for an economic situation that they have no control over, right? And if you want to break the cycle of poverty, you want to give hope to this child, that's where the Forgotten Children Fund comes in, right?
Yeah, Christmas is about hope.
It is.
And that's what we do.
Yeah, it is. And I'll take some calls. And if you want to call in and join the conversation, 360-330-5352. Good morning. Welcome to the show. You're on the air.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
Oh.
How are you guys?
Is this a real Santa?
Oh, my goodness.
Well, yes, I'm busy up here in Mrs. Claus and Snowball and all. We're working hard as we can up here. It's a different year, but I want you to know everybody's been worried about Christmas, and I've been getting a lot of letters. Christmas will always go on. I am going to be there this year. I might have to come at night, but I'm going to be there at all the presents because there's a lot of need out there this year. I've been getting a lot of letters.
Yeah, Santa, and you've been helping out a lot of kids since the dawn of time. You know, and talk a little bit, Santa, about, you know, the importance of Christmas and what Kim just mentioned, hope. Hope, hope, hope.
Well, that's the biggest thing. As we all know, Christmas brings light, Christmas brings love. And the amazing thing, especially with your community down there in Chehalis and Centralia, all of Lewis County, your people all come together to bring that hope, to give that hand up to help people in need. It's like one big family, one big happy time. Even when the troubles are here, we get through it, and there's a bright light that comes from that. And I know you're all going to pull together again and help us all pull this off.
Yeah, and we definitely are. And this is really the start of, you know, promoting the Forgotten Children's Fund and making sure that the children in our community and throughout Washington State are not forgotten. And you, Santa, I really appreciate you visiting my children too. Even in times when I didn't think I was on the good list, I got something.
Well, and that's the nice thing about Christmas. Christmas is a new beginning. Christmas is a time that we put the past behind us and we move forward. We help our brothers and sisters and mothers and fathers and aunts and uncles, and we just go for a brighter day. And together we all get through this.
Well, Santa, we appreciate you calling in and taking time from toy making and really giving us a call and giving us a pep talk and talking about hope and the importance of Christmas. Thank you.
Thank you, Santa.
Thank you. Ho, ho, ho. Gotta get back to work.
All right. Thank you, Santa. And so, I mean, that's great. I knew that the Let's Talk About It show had some famous listeners. I did not know that Santa was streaming from the North Pole.
He is. You know, speaking of hope, you know, it goes right through all processes, right? Mm-hmm. We give a love language that stretches across all borders, and it speaks to all hearts. And our hope is to give these families a hand up at the holidays so they can kind of forget for those short periods of time of what has brought them the challenges that they've been through for the year.
Yeah, and it's one of those situations that, you know, a lot of us, especially in the past week after the newest press conference from the governor and the new orders on COVID-19 and the stay-home orders, you know, a lot of charitable organizations are pivoting and saying, okay, so what can I do? How do I be effective to lifting families out of poverty, providing happy holidays? And I imagine when you saw that press conference, you said, oh man, we got to figure this out.
Yeah, Sunday was heavy. I'm not going to deny that. But here's what I know, Peter. You know, this organization, Forgotten Children's Fund, has been around for 44 years. We've been through times before. Mm-hmm. And our promise and guarantee is we will bring Christmas. Do we know what that's going to look like 100%? Not specifically, but we know that we can do that. And in our community, we will.
Right. And how many volunteers have you had in the past? Kind of elves and Santas. I mean, I know my wife and I have gone with you. We've gone with
Several people. You have a pretty solid team.
I have a great team.
Yeah.
I think Heather Stewart, Angie Brown, there's a bunch.
Yeah, Angela French.
Angela French, yeah.
Yeah,
we've
Holly,
had a good one.
You guys have a great team. You know, here's what I know is we for sure can't deliver inside of a home. I mean, you and I can't even sit 6 feet. You know, we have to be apart.
We just did a video, a quick live feed, and she started rolling her chair back, and we did it. And in the studio, we have to sit 6 feet apart. I mean, that's unfortunately, you know, whether we agree or disagree with it, the last thing we want to do is get the radio station in trouble.
Right.
Right. And that's the thing.
You know, so no matter what it is, we will provide Christmas and it will look a little different, but we do guarantee that. And you know what's really special, Peter, about our organization that, you know, in talking to our head elves, mm-hmm. is that children who receive typically come back as adults, mm-hmm. and they volunteer their time, and when they do so, it's like a absolutely generic answer is they never knew someone cared, right. and they did not feel forgotten, and that was so impactful to them that they have continued for generations.
Right.
You know, yeah. 44 years is a long time.
And you've had, and you've, even on the show, I think last year you mentioned a family who was a recipient years ago and then came back to be elves and help out delivering.
Oh, yeah. It was probably one of the most impactful deliveries I've ever done. And that was our very first year, 7 seasons ago. And they have come back and volunteered. In fact, their son finally turned of age to be an adult, to volunteer. And it was so impactful to him. And he's an elf, and it's awesome.
You know, in preparing for the show, I was going back through some of my notes and photos from past
right.
years, and I'll tell you the one probably most impactful photo for me is being Santa Claus and playing football
yes.
with a young boy on his front lawn because he doesn't have a father, doesn't have a brother, and sitting on my lap said how happy he was to get a football, but he didn't know who he would play with. And how horrible is that? Sitting there talking to this boy who probably was like 7 or 8 years old saying, I love it. I love it. I don't know who I'm going to play with. And so I'm like, let's go right now.
Yeah, let's go.
I'm playing with you. And I mean, practically my elves had to drag me out of there. I wanted to spend the rest of the day. And it really, hopefully for this child, changed his life. And he'll
Absolutely.
Always remember that moment because he believes in Santa
Absolutely.
And Santa played football with him.
Absolutely. And that's what we hope that our volunteers give. And you know, our volunteers go into this thinking, oh, we're just gonna go give a little Christmas, and they don't know how impactful it's gonna change their life.
Yep, and it changes the volunteer as much as it changed the
Amen.
Families. And that's the great thing is that
it
changes
is.
So many hearts on both sides of the giving.
Absolutely.
So, all right, we're gonna take some calls if you wanna join in the conversation, 360-330-5352. Good morning, welcome to the show, you're on the air.
Good morning, this is Mike Kimbrough.
Hey, Mike.
I wanted to remind us to keep Jesus in Christ in Christmas. The Judeo-Christian values that say love your neighbor come to us from our Christian and Judeo-Christian past. And so we want to keep Christ in Christmas. That's what I wanted to say.
Absolutely. Thanks, Mike. I appreciate it. Yeah, I mean, I think that's really important for people to, I mean, you know, look, I mean, I think this time of year is the year where you dig deep into your faith. Into your beliefs, mm-hmm. and you find ways to give back in religious ways as well as non-religious ways, ways in which you can change hearts, souls, and minds. And Santa Claus is one of those ways that we've kind of created to say, here's a giving way that is fun.
Absolutely. And we take what we're doing by sharing with our neighbors. And we just dress it up to a different level and
right.
we make it fun. You know, one of the things that we need this year that really just really sinks to my soul is, you know, we do toys and we collect toys at the local Les Schwab's that helps. But really the biggest thing to carry out our mission this year is our financial need. And that is where we are looking for help this year.
Right.
And more so in years past because our need is so great.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, looking over the last 7 seasons, we've helped over 950 families just in Lewis County, not to mention the thousands and thousands of families, you know, through
right.
the state.
And the good thing about, and if you're just tuning in, which I know you started tuning in the moment the jingle came on, Kim Witham with the Forgotten Children's Fund. We're talking about the Forgotten Children's Fund, what it does, its importance in our community, and kind of how recent events have changed in a way in which charitable organizations have to give back. And you're right. In the past, I remember having a giant box at my office, my law office downtown, and, you know, people would drop off toys. That obviously can't happen like it used to. So you're relying more than on financial gifts, gift cards. What are you looking for?
It really is about a monetary thing. You know, if we do get gift cards donated, we will utilize those. But really, our cash donations, we have the buying power to buy things in bigger quantity at less of price. And so really, unfortunately, that is where our biggest need is, mm-hmm. you know, versus years past where we have maybe had a need for coats more that year or bikes. You know, we just don't know and how it's going to look. And so really, honestly, that monetary donation just travels a long ways.
Yeah. And some of the other things, and this, a lot of people will say, well, is this all about toys? And you mentioned coats, but it's not just about toys. I mean, we would provide food, books, clothing, a bunch of stuff.
In the past, we have done many different things, but this year we just don't know what we're going to be able to do. And we just know that we are going to be able to provide a beautiful Christmas for those families. And so we are just looking for those monetary donations, but also at the same time, we continue to spread our mission, which is giving families a hand up at the holidays and bringing that hopeful cheer to them.
So if you're a business or an individual and you really want it, you're sitting here saying, all right, so how do I give? So how do they, because again, they're not dropping toys off at boxes at businesses now. So how do they get in touch with you or the Forgotten Children's Fund to be able to donate or provide financial assistance?
Our website is www.forgottenchildrensfund.org, and you can always find more information about us there. You can find us on our Facebook page. You can take your donations to Centralia or Chehalis Les Schwab. Mm-hmm. They are open. They are considered essential, and you can walk in and do that. We also have a mailing address that we'll be putting on our Facebook page. It's just easier to rattle that off.
Right. And you have social media as well and other
we
things.
Do.
I know. I think the Forgotten Children's Fund has one. Lewis County Forgotten Children's Fund, I think, also, right?
We do. And it really keeps it confusing. But at the same time, it just tells our area what we're doing for our little area.
Well, and it's important because a lot of times, you know, there's a lot of organizations that are out of Seattle or Tacoma or even out of state. This one is state.
It is here.
But it's nice to have that connection to the community so people know, hey, if I'm giving money, are we going to be taking care of some of the families
Absolutely.
In our community too? That's important.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You know.
If you're just tuning in, let's talk about it. My special guest this morning, Kim Witham with the Forgotten Children's Fund. We're talking about all the important things they do and how you can help and how just generally charitable organizations are pivoting during this time of COVID-19 and stay home orders to make sure they can continue to follow through in their mission, accomplish their mission, and provide, in this case, a very Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays to families locally. Good morning. Welcome to the show. You're on the air.
Today, I'm thinking about the lady who called you, Peter, earlier on in this week, and I just want to say for her and for you, this time, Christmas sometimes is really hard for people. One Christmas, we had just lost our home because my daughter's prescription for her disease was costing more than my husband made. And I wanted to keep it all to myself and keep it right in the circle of just our family and not say anything to anyone else. But a dear friend came along, and I was saying to her with tears, just like the lady that talked with you, and I explained what happened. So consequently, all of my kids did have Christmas. Santa Claus did come. And then I had, I think, altogether 12 chickens in our refrigerator. And it was one of the most blessed Christmases ever for us. Yes, God is still on the throne and does hear and answer prayer.
Yeah.
Thanks, Peter.
Thank you very much for the call.
Thank you. That was sweet.
I love her. She calls in all the time and we talk, and she's always that positive. And she's referencing to a woman who called in earlier this week who, with the new orders from the governor and the moratorium on eviction, she's losing money. She has one home that she rents out, and no rent's being paid. However, she still has to pay her mortgage, and she's now falling further in the red. And there are these stories all over our community and beyond, all over the country. And so, you know, the Fair and Children's Fund is not going to be able to help every single family, but boy, it can take a little chunk and change one family at a time, right?
And that's our goal. I mean, we will serve our families here from Seattle, Pierce. I mean, we serve families all over, and I'm just so blessed to just be the tool that is the vessel that goes from Seattle to here. It's really amazing.
And so some people might be asking, which families get assistance? How does that work? And in the past, I know we had worked through school counselors and identifying some families who may need help during this time of year. Are you looking at kind of a similar system? I mean, it might be hard, especially with schools not being, unfortunately.
Our whole system that we used last year, out the window, because we don't get together. Our screeners always met somewhere, and we screened our families. That is not possible. Mm. We have done a lot of Zoom, and even my volunteers, they miss that connection, you know? And so we are still utilizing the schools, and because we've taught virtually over the last several months, teachers are seeing things that are helping nominate these families that maybe we wouldn't have got to see otherwise.
Right.
And so we are still utilizing our school districts heavily.
Good. And I think that's important to identify the families that are truly in need and who you can have the greatest impact on. You're listening, Let's Talk About It, AM 1470 KELA. Maybe you're streaming KELAAM.com. Thank you. My special guest this morning, Kim Witham with the Forgotten Children's Fund. I'm going to take a quick moment for our sponsors, and we'll be back with your calls. The lines are wide open if you want to join in the conversation. 360-330-5352.
Experience matters, and Dreamweavers Real Estate has over 45 years of it. Thinking of downsizing? Let us find a house that fits your life. Thinking of selling? We provide free, no-obligation market analysis. Experience matters, and Dreamweavers Real Estate has it. We will go above and beyond to reach your real estate goals. Experience the difference today by visiting weaverland.com or call 360-273-3333. Dreamweavers Real Estate in Rochester, 273-3333.
Economic relief is here. The company president at Brim Tractor says send it now. It's the Economic Brimulus Package from Brim Tractor in Chehalis. Get $500 cash now on all tractors, skid steers, track machines, loaders, and excavators. That's $500 cash to use any way you want. Use it for your down payment, put it towards an implement, reduce the price you pay, or keep it for the holidays. Get your $500 Economic Brimulus payment at Brim Tractor in Chehalis, just off exit 74 I-5. Offer ends December 24, 2020. So get it now.
Do you think all vitamin C's are the same? They're not. Ester C is a superior form of vitamin C. It's the only vitamin C with 24-hour immune support, and it lasts up to 2 times longer than regular vitamin C. So don't just settle for any vitamin C. Buy Ester C and support your immune health today. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Meet Ingrid, fiery spirit, caring grandma, proud trucker.
I've logged more than 4 million miles in my truck. If people knew what I know, lives could be saved. I was driving outside of Ohio when a gentleman stopped suddenly in front of me. But it takes my 80,000-pound truck 200 yards to stop. I'd given myself extra room, but it's not a chance worth taking.
It's our roads. It's our safety.
Visit sharetheroadsafely.gov.
KELA.
Gotta have it in the morning.
Streaming.
Listen online.
Let's talk about it.
All right, welcome back to Let's Talk About It, AM 1470. KELA and KELAAM.com. I'm your host, Peter Abbarno, on the Let's Talk About It show. My special guest this morning, Kim Witham with the Forgotten Children's Fund. We're talking about the Forgotten Children's Fund. We're talking about making sure children and families are not forgotten during the holiday season this year. New for everybody. It's a lot of charitable organizations. The Forgotten Children's Fund pivoting. They're doing things a little different. But but staying focused on the mission of helping families during the holiday season.
Absolutely. We're just focusing on what we can do.
And the key word, even before we got on air, hope.
Absolutely.
Delivering hope. I mean, presents are one thing, food's one thing, books are another thing, but they are all a pathway to hope.
Yep, that's what we bring. We bring hope at Christmas.
Yeah, and it's one thing that a lot of us need right now. I mean, my children, a lot of students, my wife's a teacher, everybody's so frustrated right now. They're sad, they're different. Mm-hmm. Everybody can use a little bit of a pick-me-up right now. And if you're in a family that is, you know, in poverty or really, really struggling right now, the Forgotten Children's Fund can make a huge difference. And you know, it's nice that Les Schwab has been a sponsor for how long? Since the beginning of time?
I don't know really the answer to that. Maybe I can find out.
Yeah.
But I definitely know they've been a part of it for many, many years.
And it's nice to know because I remember, you know, it's a place where you can still drop off presents. And we'll give the information about where you can donate and provide financial assistance to help some of these families. But we'll go on to the callers. The lines are wide open, 360-330-5352. Good morning. Welcome to the show.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, you're on the air.
Hey. Yeah. Hey, I'm just calling. This is Mark from Les Schwab Centralia.
We were just talking about you, Mark, from Les Schwab. We were just talking about how great it is. So how long have you been involved, Les Schwab, been involved in terms of with the Forgotten Children's Fund and being kind of a focus for people to drop off gifts and help out?
Yeah, the Forgotten Children's Fund with Les Schwab has teamed up for about 8 years is all, although they've been around for years through the 70s up in the greater, you know, King County area. But like I say, my wife and I brought that down here, you know, a few years back. And you know, I just got to say, every year we get touched more and more every year by the time you drop off these gifts to a child in need. It's just a massive impact you have on your heart and on the community. You can tell kind of, you know, how these kids of need are so gracious getting these gifts. So it's a neat deal. And Les Schwab, though, has been doing a toy drive for one reason or another for longer than I've been with the company. I've been with the company 30 years.
So. Yeah. And for at least the last eight, you've been the Centralia Les Schwab has been a location where people can drop off gifts, financial assistance, all of that, right?
Yeah, both Lewis County stores, the Centralia and Stratus location. And I also want to point out, you know, we also do share, and we have in the past, with the Lewis County Foster Parent Association. So mm-hmm. we share some gifts with them as well because there's plenty of foster kids of needs. So, we've done that a long time. We're proud of our support we've been able to give and proud of our community support to help us with that.
So in addition to pulling a nail out of my tire for free if I have to pull up and I'm losing air, you also provide gifts to Forgotten Children's Fund, Foster Family Association. I mean, it's really nice to see local businesses like Les Schwab and give back to the community in which they operate. It really is heartwarming.
It is.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a neat deal. And even right now, we're wrapping up our food drive. That we're in the final stages of that, and actually we're going to team up with KLA, KMNT, and drop off our food over there with them when they do their finale here, I believe, on, is it the 11th, I believe?
You're asking the wrong guy.
I think you're right.
Yeah.
Well, Mark, I appreciate you calling in from Les Schwab, Centralia, and I appreciate all you're doing for our community, both for the Forgotten Children's Fund and all the other charitable organizations that you're a part of.
Hey, thanks, and thanks for all you do.
All right, thank you, Mark.
Thanks.
That was great. I mean, Les Schwab's been really a very important part of a lot of different charitable organizations, especially bringing Forgotten Children's Fund down here and really being kind of the center of the spoke, right?
Absolutely. They are pretty much, you know, if Mark wouldn't have gone to the Forgotten Children's Fund up north, we would have never known what it was and how to get involved.
And that's important. So getting involved, we've got about a minute left. Why don't you give the listeners the information on how they can give and where they can give one more time so that they can write it down.
So you can give electronically at www.forgottenchildrensfund.org. You can find us on Facebook and you can bring donations to your local Les Schwab Tire Centers.
Yeah, make sure you give back. I mean, the Forgotten Children's Fund is really important. All these charitable organizations are about fulfilling their mission during this really time of need, and it's becoming more and more difficult. But we don't throw our hands up. We don't give up. What we do is we double down, and we give more of ourselves to make sure our community gets lifted up. And I appreciate
thank
all
you.
You're doing.
Thank you, Peter.
Thanks, Kim. Thanks, Les Schwab, for what they're doing. And thank you for listening to Let's Talk About It, AM 1470, KELA, and KELAAM.com. Up next is a Fox News report, and then Rush Limbaugh will be back tomorrow, 8:30, like I am every weekday morning, 8:30 to 9, right here on KELA. Have a great, safe day. And, hey, and write down this call number, 360-330-5352, if you want to join the conversation tomorrow or during any show.